from the soul with it. What's going on, everybody? Dialorix TV back with another video, and I would like to discuss with you guys an article pertaining to Lakers potentially acquiring former Indiana Pacers point guard Darren Collison. This article is via Paolo Ughetti, and the headline reads, "The Lakers and Clippers may soon be at odds again, this time over Darren Collison." So this article goes on to say that on Tuesday, ESPN's Adrian Wojnarowski reported recent retiree Darren Collison is mulling over a return to the league, and the Clippers and the Lakers are two preferred landing spots. Collison retired in July at just 31 years old, and the announcement shocked many as a veteran free agent was coming off a fourth consecutive season shooting over 40% from three, and he would have likely been in line for a $10 million per year payday. The article goes on to say that not 7 months later, Collison wants back in, but the Los Angeles native doesn't want to travel too far to make his return. Collison has the Clippers in 2013-2014 and was in Indiana when current Lakers coach Frank Vogel took over the Pacers' job. It's unclear whether either team will reciprocate Collison's interest. Matt Barnes said on The Jump on Thursday that he didn't know whether Collison and Doc Rivers would get along, but both could benefit from his services. The Lakers and Clippers superstar pairs will carry them to the playoffs, but a February tweak or roster addition could be the difference in a close seven-game series. That's why Andre Iguodala is such a hot commodity on the trade market right now, and why a Collison signing will be crucial. For the Lakers, this news is God-sent. Despite starting the season 27-7, this team has plenty of deficiencies that are no longer masked. The Lakers have a tendency to revert to isolation plays and bad shots when the offense is sputtering, and their lack of depth is concerning. Sure, the fact that they can rely on LeBron or Anthony Davis coming through in the clutch offers a unique fail-safe, but that could also give the wrong impression about the rest of the roster's playoff preparedness. You can see it in flashes. The Lakers get out to a 30-point lead like they did against the Suns on Wednesday, but to keep it, they have to play both Davis and LeBron late in the fourth quarter. You can also see it in the numbers. 5 of the Lakers' 7 losses has come when LeBron has scored 23 points or less. It's not ideal that the Lakers need LeBron at 35 to score 25 plus every night to get the win. The Lakers don't have the assets to make any big trades to address these issues, save for Kyle Kuzma, which means they're likely on the outside looking in for the Iguodala sweepstakes. Waiting for the buyout market was likely going to be their play, but now Collison could be a perfect fit, and he's an ideal player for a team with shaky point guard depth. Collison could offer scoring, especially elite three-point shooting, but more than that, he's a reliable ball handler who can help lessen LeBron's role as a distributor and bio units when James is on the bench. Lastly, the article says that still the Clippers note that if the Lakers acquire Collison, it represents a tougher challenge for them in the long run. That alone could be enough motivation to try and lure Collison to the other side of Staples Center Tunnel. So if you guys would like to read the entire article, the link is in the description box. So I think Darren Collison would be a tremendous addition for the Lakers. As Matt Barnes stated on The Jump, yes, Collison can get his own shot. He's a great ball handler, and as the article pointed out, he shot 40% from the perimeter. You know, as I'm reading this article, I'm like, bruh, what in the world would make a man walk away from $10 million, bruh? I mean, $10 million, bruh. Not $1 million, not $2 million, not $3 million, not $4, not $5, not $6, not $7, not $8, not $9 million, like my good old buddy Person One, okay? But $10 million, people. So I did my due diligence, went and did my research on this man and see why he retired. This man literally retired to focus on his faith because he's a Jehovah's Witness. Now listen, I'm all for having faith. Me, myself, I don't know about y'all in terms of religion, but I'm a man of God. I'm a man of God. I believe in the Lord Almighty. Hallelujah, okay? But bruh, you telling me God would have been upset if I prayed every day and still took that $10 million a year? Come on, bruh. Come on, bruh. I mean, I would have had to change my name to RR, bruh. RR. What is that? Rich and religious. You feel me, bruh? Okay. But hey, I can't knock a man for having faith. But me personally, I ain't walking away from 10 million, okay? I ain't walking away from 10 million, okay? But anyway, I think that Darren Collison would be a great fit who can take pressure off of LeBron James and Anthony Davis. He would by far give the Lakers another threat and another weapon offensively. You know, I think that will also have a great impact on our bench because most likely Rajon Rondo will be moved to the bench and become an orchestrator for the second unit. The Lakers definitely need some improvement and need to upgrade as far as our bench. I do think that if we get Collison, we need to be tracking this man's every move, because if Jerry West gets a hold of this man and get this man in the room the same day, I mean that very same day, he will become a Clipper. I mean, the moment it's announced that Darren Collison is in the same room having a meeting with Jerry West, the logo, he's a Clipper. Instantly, he's a Clipper. Jerry West has the gift of gab and has one of the most incredible imaginations, you know, which is how he put teams together. So the Lakers need to act fast and need to act now, you know. Just reading this article, as he states, both teams can benefit from Collison's services. He says that the Clippers should go after Iguodala, but in my opinion, I think the Lakers need to stack the deck. We shouldn't be worried about competition and worry whether the league should be balanced out and things like that. We need to make it unfair. LeBron James has proven with history, his track record, he has proven that him and Adam Silver can pull off three-team trades, which NBA insiders will tell you that it's very rare to see three-team trades in the NBA. But LeBron James has the power to pull anything off. No player on this roster is safe right now. I think the Lakers should sign Collison. They create a package including maybe Kuz, Troy Daniels, KCP or Quinn Cook, Caruso, Jared Dudley, Danny Green. I mean, choose between those players and try to make a package for Andre Iguodala and try to find some way to acquire either JJ Redick or Joe Harris from the Brooklyn Nets. Because if you only sign Darren Collison, then you still need to correct your defensive issues. Those defensive issues won't just go away by signing Darren Collison. The Golden State Warriors had a super team. They had a super team for the past 2 years, and everybody, including myself, was all for it. The Lakers sucked for nearly 7 years straight. Bruh. We deserve to stack the deck, okay? We deserve a super team. Super teams are great for the league. We need a villain. The NBA lacks storylines right now. That's why it's suffering, okay? We need to stack the deck. Collison, LeBron, Anthony Davis, Andre Iguodala, DeMarcus Cousins, Dwight Howard, bruh. And you add JJ Redick or Joe Harris, bruh. Or even if you were to add Robert Covington, man, oh man, I'm telling you, bruh, we will be unstoppable. That will put us over the top, in my opinion, okay? But anyway, y'all let me know what y'all think. Y'all get in that comment box, like, share, subscribe. I'm out.